Hello friends! Today we will tell you step by step how to size canvas in standard paper sizes such as a 3, a 4, a 5, and different standards in the new Microsoft Paint with a quick tip tutorial. Our first step is to open the Paint Editor. On the left side of the status bar you can see information showing the aspect ratio of the current canvas in pixels. The last canvas width we opened was 4K in pixels and we can change it at any time. First of all, let's take a look at the paper sizes in a 3, a 4, a 5, and other standards, which are the main subject of this training, on the internet, and search for measurement information. You can access paper size standards from the Google search engine or any other search engine of your choice. As a result of the search, we have the dimensions in millimeter and inches of a 3, a 4, a 5, and other standard paper sizes. Now we will first create a canvas in a 3 size. For this, we return to the Paint Editor. From the File menu, we open the Image Properties window to see and change various settings. As you can see here, we can change the units and quantities of the canvas aspect dimensions in pixels, inches, and centimeter, and set the default setting here. The first settings we came across on the internet were in millimeter and inches. We can also set them in centimeter. We will do this by entering the measurements according to the information that 1 cm is 10 mm. For example, we will enter the horizontal, a 3 paper size, as 420 mm 42 cm for 420 mm. Of course, if there are parts that come after the dot, we will specify those parts in full. For a 3 horizontal length 297 mm, we will get the value 29.7 cm with the fraction after the dot. When we confirm, our canvas will automatically be ready in a 3 size. As you can see, the canvas has expanded. Of course, the empty parts remain transparent, and we can assign white color to them with the bucket tool. You can wipe it all off and paint the whole canvas white or any color you like. We prefer white for now. With the text tool, we add a large A3 text. In fact, we will make it invisible during the registration phase. It would make more sense to do it at a later stage. Here we have shown that we have created an A3 sheet for now, to clearly show our progress. What we need to do now is to save the white image file that we have created on the desktop in horizontal, A3 paper sizes with the name A3 paper V1, with PNG, or one of the other image formats. Of course, you can save it in the directory you want. We close the Paint Editor and open and examine the white image file that we created on the desktop, with the name A3 paper V1 and in PNG format, and the dimensions of horizontal A3 paper. We now have a ready-made horizontal, A3 paper size white image file that we can copy or use at any time. When we close and reopen the Paint Editor, it opens with its own file size, whatever the current file size is. Even when we convert the square shape here to a non-standard size, when we open another saved image file. Opening an image file and importing an image file are two different things. Don't confuse them. You will understand this better in a moment. We drag and drop the white image in a 3 paper size format onto the workspace or canvas in the Paint Editor. Another way to open the image in a 3 format is to go to the File menu, run the Open command, and then select the image file from the file directory. When we open the image, the canvas is automatically organized in the image dimensions. We can also activate the options to display in inches, centimeter, or pixels at any time in the Image Properties window in the File menu. When converting from centimeter to inches, sometimes there may be a small difference in the fractions, never a problem. As long as you already know how many millimeter it should be, you will never miss measurements. We'll close the Paint Editor again and start over. But first, let's take a look at a 4 paper sizes. We open the Paint Editor again, and just as we edited the A3 paper size canvas, we now create the A4 paper size canvas by repeating the same steps and entering the required dimensions. Since we will create vertical A4 this time, the vertical part will remain at a higher value, and we have created it. Now we save it to the desktop in the same way in PNG format, but with the name A4 paper V2 and close the Paint Editor, and examine our images saved on the desktop. And for horizontal A5, we perform similar operations quickly. We open the paint editor again and even make the canvas 10 by 10 square. We did this because, as we mentioned before, opening an image file and importing an image file are two different things. Don't confuse them, now you will understand this better. When we drag and drop the white image file, we created with the name of 3 paper V1 and in PNG format with a 3 paper horizontal dimensions it opens. Or we can also open it by going to the file menu, running the open command, and then selecting the image file from the file directory. When you open a new file, you either save the existing file or close it without saving. When we open the image, the canvas is automatically organized in the image dimensions. However, if we import a new image from file to canvas, as we will do in step 2, the situation is different. The existing file and dimensions are preserved, and the incoming image file comes with its own dimensions. We import all the paper size image files we created as separate layers. We alternate the colors of each different paper size, so you can more easily see how they relate to each other and how they differ. To make it easier to show and distinguish, we create another layer to make the three different paper sizes more distinguishable and create representative border lines. We also write the paper standard names, a 3, a 4, and a 5 on a separate layer. As you can see, two pieces of a 5 paper make an A4 sheet and two pieces of a 4 paper make an A3 sheet. We save it on the desktop in PNG format, but with the name A3, A4, A5 papers V4 and minimize the paint editor and look at the images saved on the desktop. In addition to the three different paper type formats on the desktop, we can open a newly created fully merged image and see them all. If you pay attention, only the general outlines and shapes appear here, unless you put them on top of each other in an editor or printout. The sizes appear to be the same, do not be deceived by this. Therefore, you can see the most accurate dimensions more easily in an editor like Paint or by printing them out. All these standard paper sizes are most useful for printing and similar output processes. We may prepare more detailed tutorials on printing in the future. But let's take a look at the print settings and options to show a small example. Here we can look at standard, A4 and similar paper and other paper in print settings. In this way, we can examine how these dimensions can form a basic standard dimension that helps us to convert our work into output, along with the other topics mentioned. Under the print command under the file menu, there are options such as page settings and print preview. And as we mentioned, there are A4, A3, A5, letter, legal, and many other print settings as paper size. You can see the standard paper sizes and other options available in the print settings. There are also detailed options within these standard paper settings, such as the amount of space to leave on the edges of the page, whether to print in portrait or landscape, and how many copies to print. Using these settings, you can output your work the way you want. It is very easy to edit and manipulate images at a basic level in the Paint editor. Paint is a free software available in all versions of Windows, and the new version is far superior to the old one. To get the most out of this training, following this content and our previous and subsequent or other related training series will help you understand and achieve much more. In our previous tutorials, we have provided extensive illustrative examples of Microsoft Paint, including new and old versions. So if you run into problems, our first recommendation is to review the previous tutorials. You will find many of the answers you are looking for there. Feel free to share with us what you would like to see in the next episode, what you find difficult or any comments you wish. Any feedback you can share will help us improve much of our future content. One of our goals is to help you and make it easier for you to find solutions. We will continue the series with more great trainings and we will meet you again very soon.
Don't forget to subscribe and click the bell to receive notifications for new videos. See you again soon, and thanks for watching.